गुड मॉर्निंग इनकी प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी टॉक्ड अबाउट थर्ड वेक्टर आइडेंटिटी डेल डॉट डेल क्रॉस ए. लेट अस ट्राई टू टॉक अबाउट द फोर्थ वेक्टर आइडेंटिटी डेल डॉट फाइ ए. Fourth vector identity is del dot phi a, meaning that divergence of phi a. Let us try to solve this. So this del dot phi a is equal to del dot a is a vector, phi is a scalar, phi is a scalar function, a is a vector function. This vector function a in the Cartesian coordinate system can be represented in terms of its rectangular components ax, ay, az along the axis x, y, z respectively. If we do this, this equation will become phi axi plus phi ayz plus phi azk. This is further right value of del, del or nabla. Del or nabla is the three-dimensional vector differential operator and can be written as I dou by dou x plus j dou by dou y plus k dou by dou z dot and this one phi axi plus ayz plus azk. Now take dot product of first term with these three terms, then dot product of second term with these three terms, and dot product of third term with these three terms. This is equal to I dot I dou by dou x of phi ax plus I dot z dou by dou x of phi is left here phi a y plus I dot k dou by dou x of phi az plus this is dot product of I dou by dou x with this term, with this term, with this term. Phi is also left here. Then dot product of the second term with these three terms. That will be z dot I dou by dou y of phi ax plus z dot z dou by dou y of phi ay plus z dot k dou by dou y of phi az plus. Now this is, these three terms are dot product of z dou by dou y with these three terms. And what finally left is dot product of k dou by dou x with these three terms, and that will be k dot r dou by dou z of phi as plus k dot z dou by dou z of phi ay plus k dot k dou by dou z of phi z. After getting these nine terms for dot product of this bracket with this bracket, let us use the rules of dot product for rectangular unit vectors. And what are the rules? I dot r is equal to 1, j dot z is equal to 1, k dot k is equal to 1, I dot z is equal to 0, j dot r is equal to 0, z dot k is equal to 0, k dot j is equal to 0, I dot k is equal to 0, k dot I is equal to 0. It means that out of these 9 terms, only 3 terms will survive, which has I dot I, z dot j, k dot k as the coefficient dot product, and remaining 6 term will become 0. This is I dot I 1, z dot I 0, I dot j 0, I dot k 0, z dot z 1, z dot k 0, k dot I 0, k dot j 0, k dot k 1. So only consider those terms where the dot product is 1, and ignore all those terms where the dot product is 0. Here dot product 0, the whole term will become 0. Dot product 0, whole term will become 0. Dot product 0, whole term will become 0. Dot product 0, whole term will become 0. This way 6 terms will become 0. Only 3 terms are left, and the terms left are, write the terms here, dou by dou x of phi ax plus this term dou by dou y of phi ay plus dou by dou z of phi az. Now phi is function of x, y, z. So phi is a differentiable function with respect to x as well as with respect to y as well as with respect to z. Ax only differentiable with respect to x, ay only differentiable with respect to y, az only differentiable with respect to z. Keeping this thing in mind, let us apply product formula here, product formula here, product formula here for differentiation. Using product formula of differentiation, this equation may further be written as phi dou ax by dou x plus ax dou phi by dou x. First term. Let us go to the second term. Phi dou ay by dou y plus ay into dou phi by dou y plus the last term, phi dou az by dou z plus az dou phi by dou z. Applying the product formula of differentiation to this term, this term, this term, we got these two terms for first, these two terms for second, these two terms for last. Let us go through this equation. What we see, 5 is here, 5 is here, 5 is here. So there are 3 terms, 1, 2, 3, where 5 is there, which can be taken common. If we take 5 common from this term, and this term, what left in the bracket is dou x by dou x, dou ay by dou y, dou z by dou z. 3 more terms are left. Ax dou phi by dou x, ay dou phi by dou y, az dou phi by dou z. Let us consider them in the bottom bracket. So doing this, we will have here phi into dou ax by dou x plus dou ay by dou y plus dou az by dou z plus what terms left are these? Ax dou phi by dou x plus ay dou phi by dou y plus az dou phi by dou z. Let us concentrate on first bracket. Try to remind definition of divergence of a vector. Dou ax by dou x plus dou ay by dou y plus dou az by dou z. This can be further written as phi into in the square bracket I dou y dou x plus j dou y plus k dou y dou z dot in the other bracket ax I plus ay z plus az k plus these two dou phi by dou x plus dou phi by dou y I j plus dou phi by dou z k dot ax I plus ay z plus az k. The first term I have written in the first square bracket. The second bracket I expanded into the second square bracket. Take dot product of these two. What is this? Three dimensional vector differential operator. What is this? Vector A. If we take dot product of this bracket and this bracket, we will get the same. And therefore, phi into this square bracket will be simply phi into del dot A. Phi into this square bracket is nothing but phi into del dot A plus. What is this? Del phi. I dou by dou x plus j dou y plus k dou by dou z into phi, del phi. This first bracket is del phi dot. Second bracket is vector A. And therefore, what I can write here? Del phi dot vector A. It means that del dot phi A is equal to divergence of phi A is nothing but phi del dot A plus del phi dot A. This is the fourth vector identity, del phi A, which can also be written as divergence of phi A. Putting values of del phi and A this way and solving each state, finally what we got? Del dot phi A or divergence of phi A is equal to phi into del dot A plus del phi dot A. This is the fourth vector identity recommended for our syllabus. As you see, each and every step is solved for your understanding. Hope you got this vector identity. One more vector identity is left, that is fifth vector identity. We shall deal with this vector identity in the coming lecture. Till then, thank you.